The focus of today's solemnity is life. All three readings speak about blood poured out in sacrifice, blood which for the Jews stood for the principle of life itself, blood which also stood as symbol of the covenant between God and his people, purifying blood that symbolized cleansing from iniquities that makes one worthy to worship the living God. In the Gospel account, the same symbolism comes out strong. This is the blood of the new covenant which will be shed for many. Mark's Gospel tells us that after the Passover meal, they went out to the Mount of Olives. It was there that later in the night the Lord sweated blood. In the moment of extreme agony, at a moment when he was fully aware of what his self-offering would cost him, no less than his own life. This is the life that we celebrate and extol in today's solemn feast. Undeniably, it has become difficult, if not close to impossible, nowadays to fully celebrate the feast in the traditional manner. It has become difficult, in fact, inadvisable now, to make splendid processions and construct huge altars from which to expose the Blessed Sacrament and then to bless devotees with after rituals of veneration right in the main thoroughfares. Globalization, abetted by a strong current of secularism and pluralism even in matters of faith, have conspired in the recent decades to make such triumphalistic and ritualistic manifestations of devotion look a little too medieval in approach and style. In this fast-paced and result-oriented society, the traditional pious stare accorded the mystery of the real presence of Christ in the Blessed Sacrament through the practice of the benediction of the Blessed Sacrament has taken a back seat to that which rightfully ought to be given more importance, the lively, active and live event of salvation that takes place in the celebration of the Holy Eucharist. This celebration of the Eucharist, therefore, taking place in real time, here and now, ought to be given due priority and attention by us who have chosen to take part in it. True to its primary symbolism of life, the Eucharist taking place now, the making present once again, of the sacrifice of Christ's outpouring of blood and the sharing of his body to us all is more important than merely exposing the Blessed Sacrament for adoration of the faithful. All this is to say something very important. What counts as most important is the full, conscious, lively, and active participation in the unfolding sacrifice that is now being celebrated by God's people at the Mensa Verbi, the table of the Word, and the Mensa Eucharistiae, the table of the Eucharist. Without in any way denigrating and downgrading the laudable practice of the adoration to the Blessed Sacrament, the Church through today's solemnity merely teaches us that the celebration itself of the Eucharist is a unique and special presence of Jesus in his body, the Church now gathered as one family in worship. His blood now unites us all into one body despite our differences. His blood now purifies this same body and nourishes each and every single member. And since the outpouring of blood leads to death, Jesus' death now becomes our passport to the celebration of life and unity that is what this Eucharistic celebration is all about, a celebration of Christ's body and blood. And this, my dear friends, is your kalakbay at katoto in today's episode of Puso sa Puso saying thank you and God bless you.